Welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited today because this is the first time I'm doing video with my natural hair. So do you know why I'm laughing, Seth? I'm laughing because by the time you watch this video to the end, you will laugh with me. Today I want us to look at this topic here. So what is cholesterol? Okay, the first thing is cholesterol bad? It is a misconception or an incorrect statement to say that cholesterol is bad. Do you know why? Because cholesterol is in your body. As you're looking at me now, cholesterol is in your body. It is in your blood. Whether you eat or not, is in your blood. Is that is the first thing that I'm going to answer that question with. It's part of you. In fact, it is one of the things that your body needs in order to produce some enzymes, some hormones, and even vitamin D or some body cells that it needs. So cholesterol is not bad. Are you surprised? Cholesterol is not bad. So before you argue with me, cholesterol is bad. No, so what are you trying to tell us? Please lower down and listen to me. And I know, Lord, Goddy, Lord, Goddy, Lord, Goddy, let's go. So, what is cholesterol? I'm so excited and I don't even know why. Cholesterol is a waxy substance that travels in your blood by the aid of a protein known as lipoprotein. So lipoprotein is a protein that helps the waxy substance to be able to travel in your blood, so that you are floating inside water and you don't know how to swim, and somebody is under you trying to wave your hand to make you to move inside that water. So that is the function of the lipoprotein. So the lipoprotein carries the waxy substance known as cholesterol inside your blood. This cholesterol, their function is it helps your body to produce hormones, enzymes, and some body cells. Then you will ask me, if this cholesterol is in my body, where in particular is it being produced? The cholesterol in the body of a newborn, the cholesterol in the body of an adult is produced primarily by the liver. It's the liver that produces this cholesterol. So once it produces it, it will push it into the body through the help of lipoprotein. So the lipoprotein will now carry it and circulate it around your body where it is needed. There are two types of this lipoprotein. We have high density lipoprotein cholesterol, also known as the good cholesterol. Then we have low density lipoprotein cholesterol, also known as the bad cholesterol. Let me explain to you why either of the two is called good or bad. The high density lipoprotein cholesterol is often described as the good cholesterol because it helps in returning the excess, because the cholesterol, once the liver produces it, it will push it to the blood system. After circulating, the body will take the ones that it needs, whereas there will be excess in the blood. So it's this high lipoprotein cholesterol that returns those excess cholesterol back to the liver. It will return it back to the liver. Once it comes back to the liver will now convert it to bile. It will convert it to bile. So that bile will either be used for digestion or it will be excreted. So why the name good is given to it is that it helps the body to get rid of excess cholesterol that circulates within our body. Do you understand? Then the second one is the low density lipoprotein cholesterol, also known as the bad cholesterol. Why it is called the bad cholesterol is, first of all, it is larger in quantity. The low density, the quantity is larger in the body than the high density lipoprotein cholesterol. And the function of this low density lipoprotein cholesterol is that it carries, once the liver produces this cholesterol, the low density lipoprotein cholesterol will take it around the body. It will be transporting it to different cells of the body, to different organs of the body. And you know, all these things, they pass through the artery wall. The artery is a vessel through which blood is supplied to the body. So now look at why it is being called a bad cholesterol. Why they call it bad cholesterol is that even as it is transporting this cholesterol that your body needs, It doesn't mind when the cholesterol level increases. When there is excess cholesterol level in your blood, this low-density cholesterol will keep on transporting. It will keep on circulating it. Before you know it, large number of cholesterol will start depositing on the walls of the arteries. It will continue depositing on the walls of the arteries, and before you know it, instead of the walls of the arteries will be clogged. If the wall of the artery is this big, because of the deposition of the cholesterol carried by the low density lipoprotein, it will be clogging. Before you know it, the space will be too small for blood to pass through, and in some cases that clogged stuff will now burst, and if it bursts it will enter into the blood, causing clots and other things. And before you know it, you see that such a person will have heart related diseases. This will lead us to the symptom. Somebody said, but I don't have cholesterol because I'm not showing any sign or symptom. Why I want us to look at this sign or symptom is cholesterol. Most times, high cholesterol level doesn't show you any sign. In fact, before you start seeing any sign at all, it must have gotten to a larger level. Maybe it is not higher than 100 or higher than 130 now, the abnormal stage up. So before somebody will start showing signs, just like hypertension is a silent killer. There is no way that you can see physically signs of high cholesterol. It is only when the cholesterol level must have put that person down and the person goes to hospital for checkup that we will know. And among the signs is that it comes with chest pain. The safest way to know your cholesterol level is just to go for periodic health checkup, maybe once a year or twice in a year, depending on how you want. But you cannot sit down in your house and boast that you don't have cholesterol. You need to go and check it so that you will rule out that. And so I know you must have seen the reason why I was laughing at the beginning of this video. Do you now see that your body, that you have cholesterol in your body, and in fact your body needs it? So nobody born of a woman, created on this world, can say that he or she doesn't have cholesterol. So beware when people are selling products to you that it will make you not to have cholesterol. It's different from that, it will help you to lower your low density cholesterol. So this is the end of today's class, and I hope by now you must have been grinning from one ear to the other because of the rich topic that you just delved into. So thank you so much for listening. Thank you for being part of today's class. And if you've not subscribed to this channel, please click the notification button down there. Subscribe to the channel. There is a subscribing button. Click the bell by the side as well. Then share the video. Like the video. You know how to like it, share to your friends, and also tell people about this. Thank you so much for listening. I'm Amara Ozadigbe, a registered nurse midwife. Please watch these two videos here. Watch either of the two. It is very interesting. Make sure you watch them. And see you next time. Bye.